Welcome to Discover Deutsche Bank, where we aim to show you what life at Deutsche Bank is really like. My name is Philipp, and I am the host of this episode. Today, I'll introduce you to Jennifer Meyer from our technology center in Cary, North Carolina. Jennifer is working as an associate and trains Deutsche Bank colleagues on everything related to cloud technology. Find out why Jennifer thinks that the banking industry is an especially interesting space for tech talent and how this all relates to her owning a dog daycare. Let us discover Deutsche Bank. Hi, Jennifer. Great to have you on board of Discover DB, and a warm welcome from my living room here in Berlin, Germany, to our Cary Technology Center in North America.
It's a lovely day here in Cary. How are you doing there in Germany today?
I'm absolutely fine. Jen, great to have you on board. I'm going to cut right to the chase. I've heard you had a dog daycare business. Why would you give up working with cute dogs to go back to working in tech?
Well, Philip, the answer to that is I had actually been in IT for more than a decade, and I had been volunteering with a variety of different animal welfare organizations for all of the 2000s. After about a decade, I decided that I wanted to turn my hobby into a business. Did you know that 95% of new businesses fail within their first year? And of the remaining 5%, 95% of those fail within the next 5. Everybody thinks they're going to buck the trend on that one, but I didn't. And so when I closed my business, I decided to come back to IT.
Well, what a great story. So from dogs to tech. So you joined Deutsche Bank about 2.5 years ago and started out on the production team. And not too soon after that, you acquired the nickname Jennifer Hackathon. Can you maybe explain that a little and describe what your current role is?
I wouldn't exactly call Jennifer Hackathon a nickname per se, but when I'd been here about 3 months, I volunteered to take part in a Deutsche Bank sponsored coding competition. And to my great astonishment, my team won second place globally ahead of 118 other teams. That just rocketed me to instant stardom inside the technology, data, and innovation division here. It seemed like for the next 6 months, all I heard was Jennifer, hackathon, Jennifer, hackathon. The hackathon is our big coding competition every year where thousands of people are involved. Usually there's 1,200 to 1,400 actual software developers that are coding in teams of 10. And it's a 24-hour event. Each year it's devoted to addressing some charitable cause and trying to find a technological solution to help people out. We also have a lot of smaller coding competitions every year. In December, we have Advent of Code, where people have to solve coding problems and compete against that. There was Code Hero back in September. We've done a couple of just internal hacking competitions to see if we can break applications. So basically, at least once a month, sometimes two or three times a month, there is some sort of game that revolves around coding and helps to make the business a better place, and sometimes the world.
And what is your current role?
I help teach other students to work in the cloud. And then I help recruit from the local colleges and universities. We're especially looking for people who have cloud experience and certifications.
I also know that you have a lot of experience in different tech roles. You've worked in consultancy, for an education service provider, and even some public institutions like the Air Force or the Navy. How does it feel switching to the banking industry, and what is the main difference or advantage you've experienced?
Well, Philip, when I joined DB, I didn't really think about banking and technology in the same sentence. But what I've realized since I did join DB is that banks handle a lot of money on a daily basis. And all of that money exists as ones and zeros. People get upset when you lose their money. If you were to sell books, for example, and you lose track of a couple of copies of Harry Potter, it's likely to be an internal issue and the customer's never going to know about it. And even if the customer did see it, you send them another copy and it's over and done. The banking industry doesn't have that kind of leeway. For example, if London were struck by an earthquake and we completely lost that data center, we have to have that money backed up someplace and hopefully multiple someplaces. Do you keep 3 cars in your driveway just in case you get a flat tire on one car? Probably not, right? But if you were in the trucking business, that's going to happen, and it's probably going to happen several times a day. It's an eventuality, and you have to be prepared for it. The banking industry treats human error, acts of God, and hackers not as, oh, maybe it'll happen someday, but it's going to happen, and probably sooner or later. These risks are real, and Deutsche Bank plans for them, which is something that's very, very unusual in tech, recognizing that these are risks and we need to do something about them long before it happens.
What would be your recommendation for someone coming from a non-banking background and joining Deutsche Bank in tech?
There are things about working for a bank that are new to me, like the tight regulations, the really high focus on security and redundancy, and extreme attention to detail. But frankly, tech is tech. I don't think of it as the banking industry. I work in a tech center that has really well-defined business processes and management that focuses on being proactive rather than reactive. I think banking is a really good industry for anyone who's interested in cybersecurity and artificial intelligence, because as a bank, we are a very high value target for hackers and state-sponsored threats, which means security is our top priority. And it's my firm belief that the future of banking lies with the bank that has the fastest supercomputers, the best algorithms, and the smartest artificial intelligence available.
So you've already told some things about what are the characteristics of working in tech and banking, but what is the impact you can have here at DB in tech?
Because of the whole hackathon thing when I started, I've kind of had the ability to form my own career here at Deutsche Bank. As you said, I started out in production support, and now I work in something that's completely different. I don't even touch production systems. I just teach people who are going to be working in the cloud how to get the skills that they need. So it's a very, very different role, but what Deutsche Bank has done is played to my strengths, which are teaching and are public speaking and tech. And so all of those have been rolled into one big bundle. Now, my role isn't just focusing on one system and supporting that. My role is focusing on all of the technology, data, and innovation here at Deutsche Bank and reaching all of my other coworkers at the same time. I have basically an impact on the whole tech organization here.
And so we know that you work in Cary. How is the working environment in Cary? Or more precisely, do I have to wear a student tie to come to work every day?
No, you don't.
Good.
You know, 2 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, my boss came from an event at a local university, and he showed up at a meeting in a suit and tie. I was completely blown away and ragged him about it the rest of the day. people here wear what they're comfortable with. And frankly, that was the first time I'd ever seen him in anything besides a t-shirt or sweatshirt. Some people do wear jeans and a t-shirt every day. Some people wear jeans that have holes. But it's a matter of individual preference.
What training does DB offer?
Tons of it. When I first started, as you said, I started out in a production support role. So I spent that time using Deutsche Bank's in-house training. I studied economics, unemployment, equities, derivatives, credit swaps, trading. Frankly, economics has never been something that I'm interested in, and certainly not something I knew about. And I learned that in my first 3 months at the bank. And of course, now I'm in a teaching role and teaching students to move into the cloud. I've studied everything since I've been here, from personal branding, which honestly I'd never given a thought about before, to Google Cloud Platform and other cloud technologies, mobile application development. It's been a learning journey.
So you're not just getting thrown into the cold water?
No, not by any means. If you want to learn it, Deutsche Bank will figure out a way for you to learn it. And they even offer educational support.
I know that one topic is very close to your heart, and that is neurodiversity. I love that you are so open about this. So maybe can you explain to our listeners and me why this is such an important topic for you and how Deutsche Bank supports you in your day-to-day life?
Well, Philipp, my life has ranged from the unconventional to the just plain bizarre, which means that I've ended up experiencing the world in a profoundly different way that other people do. And most of my coworkers here didn't grow up within 1,000 miles of where I grew up. We come from different continents, from all over the world. And we come here together in Cary to create something that is really unique. And we build on each other's strengths. As for my own neurodiversity, I'm not going to go into a whole heck of a lot of detail, but let's just say that when I revealed how neurodivergent I was last year, nobody batted an eyelid. I've never heard the term psychologically safe before a couple of months ago. But that pretty much describes the environment here. It's a really amazing experience.
Great. Thanks for being so open about this. And thanks overall for the interview and your time. While, of course, Deutsche Bank can compete with cute dogs, we're so glad you've made the switch to DB. And it was really great having you on our show. Thank you.
You're welcome, Philipp. It was really great being here this morning.
Thanks for listening. If you want to explore career opportunities at Deutsche Bank, have a look on our careers page at careers.db.com or follow us on social media. We'd love to get your feedback and hope to hear us again at Discover Deutsche Bank.